In this video, I'm gonna teach you to shoot like the Finnish beauty, Patrick Laine. Now, if you haven't already seen it, you can check out part one. Have you checked out part one, Patrick? Where I go over the four keys to shoot like Laine. And in this part, I'm gonna go over a second type of shot. Because in the first video, how to shoot like Laine part one, we go over this style of shot, but this is only one style of shot that he uses. So in this video, we're gonna go over some of his keys to a shot that we call bum bum bum, the kick shot. You see that kick there? So if you're watching right now and you want to know who I am, my name is Jason Yee. I'm a professional hockey player and a kinesiologist, and I love using technology, science, and psychology to break down NHLers and then instruct myself and players and learn from them. I have helped hundreds of thousands of people online, and really excited to go over this next shot with you. So, we'll go over kind of the three keys of the kick shot. Let's get started. So here's a good example of the kick shot, and you'll see it a few times. And the difference is that rather than keeping both feet on the ground, Laine kicks his back foot up. And we see this shot with Goudreau a lot, and we'll go over the kind of the mechanics, the physics behind why. So what you see when he comes in like this is he's setting up in a very similar way, but because he's cutting across the ice, he needs to get his momentum towards the net. He's headed this way. On the other shot that we go over in part one, again, link two if you want to watch that, he's kind of usually backing up or almost stationary. With this shot, he's usually on the move, and we'll show you where he's coming in on the right wing. But in this situation, he's coming across, so he's got to get his momentum towards the net. One thing that we see is this stick isn't really functioning like I think a lot of coaches will say, which is that you need to lean down, push down on the stick. What we see is that it acts more like a lever. And once you understand how you can really maximize that leverage, look at the position of the stick right now to here, where he changes the position of the lever, and then he really is going to twist his body, crank this backhand in, boom, and you can see that last little bit here is that real leverage. Now, why do I bring this up is because what he is doing with this bottom hand, like I said, isn't pushing down into the ice, he's moving the pivot point forward. So when he moves the pivot point forward, now it provides this platform for this top hand to really pull back, boom, like that. And that's where you get kind of the majority of that action of the stick is with this pull back here. Now, in order to get this bottom hand here, he also needs to get his shoulders and chest aiming towards the net. And I'll show you from this angle. You can see how his shoulders are kind of here, and then he has to twist them towards the net in order to get that forward hand motion. So you can see how far his hand moves from right around his knee to way over here, there, like that. And like I said, I think a lot of people see this as a push or like some sort of bizarre leaning slash pushing motion, but it's really a pivot, right? It's like a lever right there like that. Now, why this back leg kicks? Everything is connected, and every movement has some sort of equal and opposite movement. So if I'm gonna be able to drop this chest here, I need to be able to counterbalance with the leg. And you know, I think you see a lot of players use this shot. I'll bring up, so you see it here, same thing. The bottom hand has to move towards the net, the shoulders have to twist, and the chest has to drop. And then in order to counterbalance that rotation, this thing needs to kick. That's also gonna allow for better hip rotation. And as we know, the shot isn't a push, so weight transfer is less important than rotation. In fact, rotation is numero uno. And that's kind of how you do the kick shot. Now, you might look at this and say, oh, I already do this, or I already know this, and you know, I don't need to be shown how to do the kick shot. And that's like an entirely fair thing to say and to think. What I'm wanting to do here, what I'm aiming to accomplish with Train 2.0 is to say, often there's coaches that are belittling or, you know, usually discouraging players from techniques that NHLers are obviously doing. There's another example of the kick shot right there. And so I don't want anyone to ever think that they're doing a mechanic wrong just because a coach hasn't said that it's correct. So the approach that I like to take is that you view your movement as an experiment and you test these movement hypotheses. And then you do what's called feel your body learning. And if you can get the right feeling plus consistent results, that's probably the magic mechanics. Now, how do you design these movement experiments? Well, one thing we look at is the quality of the experiment that you're running. So with the Train 2.0 membership, what we've done is we've created these movement experiments. We've created, you know, what we think is an upgraded library of NHL mechanics so that you can test out things faster and you can really get those NHL mechanics even quicker. Test them out, experiment with them, and then feel your body learning. And if you would like to know a little bit more about my philosophy with this, you can check out my Instagram at Train 2.0 or listen to the podcast, which is the Train 2.0 show, searchable anywhere that you get your podcasts. So thank you very much for listening today, and I'd love to hear what you think. Please leave a comment on what you think about the kick shot and what you've learned so far. Thanks for watching.